Hello guys, my name is Naveed and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss very interesting Python library. That name is Manim. So what is Manim? Actually, Manim stands for Mathematical Animation Engine and was created by Grant Sanderson to produce the high precision math animation videos. So the main objective of 3Blue1Brown channel and this Python library is to complement traditional textbook based math learning with visual intuition, with very attractive intuitions. So currently there are, you can say there are two versions of this Manim library. First one is original library that is created by Grant and the fork version maintained by Manim community. So we will use the community version in this video. So if you want to understand Manim, so we can say Manim was created as a bridge between FFmpeg video. Here you can see what is the definition, what free and open source software project. So it is the bridge between FFmpeg video encoding engine and Python. Since you cannot communicate built-in Python data structure to FFmpeg, so Manim implements several mathematical object representation and animation classes for you. So I have created this Jupyter notebook. I will upload this notebook on GitHub repository. So you can download, simply upload and run it. First of all, we need to configure, install Manim. Then we need to install Manim library from pip, and then we can start using this. So first of all, click on runtime, change runtime, GPU, save, click on connect. It is connecting, initializing, connected, great. So we need to first run, simply these are the commands that we run on Linux. So don't worry, simply run this cell. I will upload this notebook on GitHub repository. You can download. So this, there are no worried about it, like how you can install, how you can configure it. Simply run this cell. It will start installing some libraries. After install running this cell, you need to restart your runtime. Okay, so just click on this button, restart runtime, click on yes. Here you can see it is, oh okay, it is again connected. So now check to run this cell, either Manim has import or not. Great, so we have successfully installed Manim. So first of all, this line is import all the content of library. So this is the recommended way of using Manim. As a single script, often use the multiple name of Manim namespace. Next one is, now we'll create the animation, like how we can create a circle and fill that circle with the pink color. So first we'll discuss these two lines, like what is the function, like class create circle, then the parent class scene, then we define the function define construct and self. Actually, most of the time, the code for scripting and animation is entirely contained within this construct method of scene class. So inside construct, we can create objects, display them on screen and animate them. So next two lines, circle is equal to circle and circle.set fill is pink and opacity 0.5. Actually, these two lines create the circle and set its color and opacity. Last line, self.play create circle. Actually, finally, the last line, use the animation create to display the circle on your screen. And what is this? Actually, now you're thinking, why? What is this line? Actually, we need to write this command in our command prompt. But don't worry, Jupyter Notebook allow this feature to you. Simply write 2% sign and write the whatever command you run on your command prompt. Simply write manim-qm-v warning, and here should be the create circle, the class that you want to run. Simply click on run cell. Yeah, great. So there, here is your first animation. Next one, we will change square to circle. Run this cell. Here you can see square, circle. Okay, next one is sine curve unit circle. This is very interesting. Okay, now run this cell. This sine curve unit circle. Simply run this and let's see our interactive animation. Oh, here you can see. Yes, this is interesting. So the same animation that three blue one brown channel make. So you can draw same animation. This one, like if you want to zoom in your camera, like following graph camera, like you zoom out. Run this cell. Here you can see. Interesting. Next one is argument minimum example. Run this cell and let's see the animation of this cell. Next one is moving angle. Like, you know, the angle between, like if you want to show someone, like this is that 45 angle, 90. Run this cell and let's see the animation. Yes. And last one is Boolean operation. Let's see the animation of Boolean operation. Intersection, union, and exclusion. So you can see this is very interesting. So you can create different animations like this. So if you want to explain your problems to someone, so you can create different animation and make the interactive math with respect to traditional, just like a theory. So you can make the interactive realization. So you can, student will get more interactive, will get more involved in your class. So that's it for today. If you like my video, please hit the subscribe button, click on the bell icon. Let's meet another.